And good evening. Got to start with a cigarette here. And you're going to need one after you hear what's got coming up tonight. Come on in, Gary Brodsky Show, live. This is going to be a scary ride tonight. Okay. Now, I don't even know where to start, but I'm starting now, I guess. And my foot is caught in a cable. Okay, well, we're ready to go here. Now, this is from 1969. No, it's not a song, it's not music. It's what we call real white papers, okay? This is the real deal. This is what they planned for people today. Are you ready? Restructure of the family. Not that you have an idea how you're going to structure your family. They are going to tell you and indoctrinate you subliminally, okay? Restructure of the family. Encourage increased homosexuality. Educate and deceive for family limitation. Encourage women to work. And this goes on and on. Reduce or eliminate children's or family allowances for fun and recreation. Bonuses and incentives perceived to have people stay in the workforce who don't need to be there. Get women under 45 to get busy in all sorts of activities other than marrying or have children. Now, this is from the memorandum to Bernard Berylson, Population Control, Frederick F. S. Jaffe, World Population. This was not only proposed, it was accepted. Now, chronic depression is on here. Kind of interesting, right? How they plan to use all the stuff in your drinking water to not only make you sterilized, but make you depressed. So, okay, now, that they've already checked off on the list. That's been done. What has not been done yet is confined by law, and this isn't the worst, this is going to happen. Only a limited number of children per adult, small housing, oh, you get special payments for sterilization. And it goes on and on and on. This doesn't bother me as much as the people cooperating with this. The people go, yeah, you know, this is all good. And that's what this society has become. People cooperating with this crap. Okay, if you want a copy, email me. I'll send it to you. It's out there. It's real and it's happening. And they are doing it to people all over the place. And the big thing here is to kill all passion, all drive and you see the zombies everywhere. I have to tell you that. You know that. You've seen it. Just open your window, walk out your front door. And that is the big way to get you, to make you a zombified person, totally zombie out. And if you don't see them, and if you do see them, don't realize, well, I am going to do an impression of them in a second, because I am just so sick of their people, because they're going to use the media and the water to control you. How do you fight that? Very simple. And I hate to be saying this, I'm not pushing my own product. This works, okay? The Ultra Life Gold. It's at GaryBrodsky.com supplements. Or you can go to NewUltraHealth.com, same thing. This works, because you don't even know how depressed you are until you take this. You're like, wow, I just dropped about 3,000 pounds of depression. I'm going to take some right now. I think I may have a question here. I made it slower so it doesn't disturb everybody. Wow, it's so low. What the heck is this? This can't be right. Oh, okay. James, how are you? Hi, Gary. Greetings from Canada. Your audio programs are great. You talk about guys being less masculine these days. Something I've noticed lately. Some guys are wearing scents that smell like a woman's perfume. That's pretty fucked up. Do you have any tips for getting younger women? Thanks, James. James, that question is a really good question. I don't know how old you are, but I can give you the tips on getting younger women right now. And they're really easy. Because you know what you have to do? Nothing. Done. And I'll explain why. Younger women are so sick of the effeminate guys that an older guy is average. The average girl, 20, is dating a guy in their 40s now. So that's happening right now. I mean, it's amazing. So yeah, there's no special tips. If you're older, you have an advantage. You see how, I was gonna do an impersonation, how wimped out these guys are? It is beyond belief. Hey, Jason. Good evening. Hi, Gary, Jason here. You're right on. If you go to any regular person's house, you see family separated with a TV and a computer in every room. Thanks, Jason. Jason's just getting warmed up. But that's true, because people don't know how to talk to each other anymore. Now, I'm going to gold myself up, because only a fool wouldn't. And I'm serious. Drinking water, fluoride in there, and, yeah, lithium is now in the water. I killed it right on the spot. Goodbye. Everybody is depressed. Oh, you want proof, do you? Okay, I got proof. Go to your drugstore and look at what's on sale. Every antidepressant known to man. 1/3 of all kids, and I say kids, I'm talking about 17 to 25, is on antidepressants or mood stabilizers or ADD medication. Special needs, every one out of 16 kids. And nobody says, you know, something seems to be wrong here. Well, something is wrong here. I'm going to take a quick soda break because I am on a roll. If you want to get me questions, just type in text to GaryBrodsky123@AOL.com. And I am going to drink some soda now, which, by the way, is not allowed in New York. I got four cans tonight.
When you wake up in the morning and the light is red, your hair, the first thing you do when you get up out of bed is hit that pizza running and try to meet the masses. Go get yourself some cheap sunglasses.
Okay, questions are coming in. Gary, is success, power, and conquest and power, are they the same? No, they're actually different. I know they sound the same, but they're different and they're great. One got lost, and I did something completely different. And then, hey, I recovered it, and I put it up there. So it has a similar name, but it's different. And that's another thing. Guys are not concerned about ambition anymore, passion, women. I mean, how many of you see this? Let me know. I'm here. I see this at the beach all summer. I just go there to watch. I look at girls on the beach, okay? I'm abnormal by today's standards, right? You're on the beach and you watch these guys and the hottest girls walk by. Guys don't look. Now, another thing, men and women, the differences between men and women today are very different than they were, let's say 10, 15, 30, 40, 60 years ago. The big difference is all the stuff that affects men, the poison water, the brainwashing, the TV, low frequency sound, doesn't affect women. And here's the proof. Go to any school and look at the special needs section. It's all guys, because guys are just built differently. It's accepted easier. Very few women have autism. You don't see too many girls with it. You see all these guys that have taken the bait. And of course, everything is fixable. But people go along. They go along with what society tells them. The same society that got them in that is not going to get you out of it, okay? And the big thing is they got guys castrating themselves based on false information. It's enough to drive you nuts. I'm about ready to go there, but not yet. Cigarette break, and I will be right back.
Understand me now. Sometimes I feel a little mad. But don't you know that no life can all be an angel? When things go wrong, I seem to be mad. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Okay, I'm back. You gotta check this because it's all quiet. Nothing in yet. But here's how most guys act today. I'm right, you're wrong. And, okay, let me get this question. I got some great impersonations coming up. Hey! Carl, how are you? Good evening, Carl. Hey, Gary, I'm 18. And guys my age are getting hit hard with the brainwashing. And I think one big factor besides the media is the schools. Carl, you are so right. It was the worst 4 years because I was aware of it. Also, what sort of stuff do they add to drinking water? Well, Carl, you're right. The schools, I haven't been to school in many, many years. But schools are brainwashing and indoctrination centers. You know, what are they teaching in the second grade? Gay education. Jimmy has five dads. You know, what's next? Jimmy has a horse for a father? And they make it seem like that's normal. You know, this has been done before in history. They you know, the cultures have developed. But hey, killing is normal. It's good. History is written with all the psychotics, okay? But the big question here, and I just lost my train of thought. Was, okay, what they add to drinking water? Sodium fluoride, which reduces your IQ and makes you passive. Now, this was done during the Nazi era. That's why you see four guards guarding 1,000 people and nobody's jumping them. Why? Give them fluoride. They go along with anything. Now, that's what has happened to people today. Now, if you're aware of it, it means you have resistance to fluoride. But it's got to be torture going to school, seeing this stuff happen to other people. And you hear it when guys speak. They're like, 1 second. They're like this. Well, I'm right, you're wrong. I'm dating girls. I'm going to tell you how to get girls. They don't even have that much passion in their voice. It's like, I'm right, you're wrong. I'm going to tell you how to get girls. You know, really sad cases. Why? Men used to do men's things, lift heavy weights, martial arts, a little trouble here and there. That's the problem with kids today. They're not that bad. They just sit there all day playing goddamn video games. And they go, you think girls will find me attractive? No, you have absolutely no sexuality. Jason again. Hey, Gary, Jason again. Hey, how did I know that, huh? All right, Jason again. When I was growing up in the 80s, we had parties every night and everyone got together at the roller skating rink and the beach, and life was fun. It was great. And nobody knows how to talk to each other on their all the antidepressants. You know, that just reminded me, I was growing up in the 80s too. Beach parties every night, fires, wild stuff. I remember, racing cars, drag racing on the street, and the cops would pull you over. Hey, you don't do that again, all right? All right. That was an easy thing to settle. Now, I have a Prius. Now teenagers are living in a computer fantasy world. And the same computer receptors that pick that up, guess what they do? They kill sexuality and passion. They live for the game. And it's an old weapon. It was started in Rome, called bread and circuses. Dakota, how are you? Good evening, sir. This is the show I've been waiting for. Finally, you are the hero, and everybody should know that. Thank you for everything you do. You rule. Dakota, you know I'm going to have to play your song now. You're going to have to wait. Dakota's getting the song. Oh, no, that's too wild for you. Dakota, give me a second. I'll get you a good song here because I need a break myself. This is Dakota's song here.
My Bellamy, you were a child of the sun and the sky.
I'm tired of this one.
My Bellamy, on the two level, je te dis merci, merci. You were the answer, all of my questions.
Dakota,
I want to tell you that I adore you, I always do. But you amaze me by leaving me now and starting you. My Bellamy, I'm in love with you. Let the bells ring.
From David, Gary, seems like everyone wants a piece of me. Sorry, David. It just took me by surprise. This week, people in cars shake their fists at you for nothing. I'm out in the garage and people hear the phone. People think I ignore them on purpose and deserve every disrespect. Like some sort of curse. The thing about it is, I usually start out in a great mood, then boom, lightning strikes me. How do I protect myself from this? David. David, that's how the world has become today. A bunch of negative guys who want to be right. And, you know, if this was another time, another place, another century, or another decade, I'd say just kick the crap out of them. And I'll tell you something. When you show any type of toughness, people back down. And it's easy to be tough. I'll explain how to be tough. Just repeat. It's like, what are you doing over there? What am I doing over where? That's it. Just repeat back to them. Because it screws up their mind because they're hearing the same words they put out. An example of being tough. I was at a cash machine once and I was really just getting out my last cash because I was in a little bit of financial problem. And the guy pulls the gun on me and he goes, give me your money or I'll shoot you. I said, shoot me. And I knew I had about 3 or 4 seconds to grab the gun out of his hand. Because he lost control because I told him what to do. And he's thinking, wait a second, aren't I in charge of that? Before he could process the information, I had the gun, threw it on the floor, opened it up, dropped the clip, called the cops, which I hate to do, but I'm not going to leave a gun on the street. I'm not going to take home one that has possible bodies on it. And just get back into people's face. Okay. Gary, can you hold up your ring to the camera So it looks like just like my dad's. Well, I don't know which one you're talking about. This one or that one. Well, thank you, Juan. Gary, people are into the stupid media, so they don't care. And worship stupid rappers like Lil Wayne, Drake, and R&B artist Usher. People worship idols, okay? Idol worship never meant a statue. Okay, let me just get this down. When they say don't worship idols, there was a bunch of guys sitting around going, no, we got to worship something. Hey, Louie, come here. Can you make us a statue we can worship? Yeah, here's a chisel, and there's a big rock out there. You know, when you're done, let us know. Come on, you don't have that statue yet? We got to do some worshiping here. No, that's not what idol worship actually is. People think it's like these stone things. Yeah, we can't move now because we built this thing out here. We got to. No, it's worshiping people on TV or actors. I mean, that's the way they get you, because everything you say, if you think about it, you've heard it in a movie or a show somewhere. Okay, let me get to some more questions here. How long should I ignore a woman until she starts thinking, aren't I good enough? Don't ignore them. Okay? Don't ignore. Move in fast. Guys don't move in at all. Guys don't even look at all. Move in and be alpha. Now, this is on one of the audio programs, How to Be Cool. And it is a great program. If you don't have it, it's like 10 bucks at GaryBrosky.com. When you move in, you've got to move in slow. Talk slow. If you ever notice the cool guys' movies, what makes them cool is they don't overreact. I'm going to give you an example. Okay, a cool guy, for example, Vito Corleone, The Godfather, he was cool because he didn't go, oh my God, they killed Sonny, what am I going to do? They, I want all inquiries made. I want no acts of vengeance. They don't lose their cool, and that is cool, is keeping it cool. Great program, How to Be Cool, on sale now at GaryBrosky.com. The plus sign hits. I'll answer that, I promise, on the next show. I'll even keep it here to make sure that if I forget, it comes back. Can you dedicate a song to the code for me, because she's great? Thanks. She is great. I don't have the song, but I will dedicate a song for you. Call again. Are there any places in this country where people are less like zombies? Sorry to disappoint you, Carl, but this is a new world order. That means the world. El mundo. There's no way around it. But there is a way. Don't be part of it. Get other people not to be part of it. And Dakota, there's a song coming up for you. You better be watching this, because this is a song dedicated to you from somebody else. No, I can't. This just seems to fit Dakota. Just perfect, right? So I'm happy. Junior, follow the alpha males. All of you guys are, but this guy kicks ass. Hey, Gary, I do not know what's going on, But just like last week, I can't get you on, Facebook, YouTube, or Ustream, right? I don't know what's going on either. Gold gives me great erections. Thank you. Yeah, of course it does. That's why I don't want anybody doesn't want to get this. It's the price of gold is going sky high, and it looks much better in the way you present yourself and the magnetism you create than it does wearing it. If I could drink this, I will. And one day I'm gonna melt it down and drink it. I can care less about it. All right, Alex, how you doing? Monday, yes, that'll be happening on Monday or Tuesday. We want to build them right. Okay, come on, questions, Gary Brodsky, 123 at AOL.com. We got a lot of people out here. And Dakota, I want to hear from you again. Question, anything. Jason, let him go. Junius, pop him in. I know he can't see me, I don't know why. Ask me computer tech questions. It's like, yes, it's Stevie Wonder. Will you be my chauffeur? Hello, Gary. I'm going to buy your Wishes on Command. What more can you say about it? Well, it's 6 hours long, so I can't really say the whole thing, but it really is about how men and women react with each other, how women want a guy to take control, how to do it right, and make a woman happy, who will then in turn make you very happy. It's a great program. And the plus sign has said, does gold, silver, and copper help build lucid dreaming? Yeah, everything is going out. We had a run on gold, silver, and copper like you would not believe. So, yeah, it's all here tomorrow. There's a big delivery coming. If you want to order it as soon as possible. Because otherwise, you know, there's a waiting list. And we are paying more for gold and silver right now than ever before. And it does change your life in about 10 minutes. Yes, Jason, absolutely. And yeah, about the occult powers, yeah, I'm going to have a special show dedicated to that. But I do take the Alpha Bumi and DHEA because it works. You've got to build up testosterone. This guy who's 18 years old, Carl, he's got high testosterone. I'm sure he's a cool guy, smart guy, sharp. Would protect his friends because he's got high testosterone. He's lucky, but he can always make it a little bit higher. I almost lit this until he's smoking. So, yeah. Oh, I gotta play some music here. It's halftime. Well, after that question, of course. That goal just felt great. I'm just going to sit here and enjoy it. Because you're going to have to fight back. And I'll tell you one thing goal does, eliminates approach anxiety. And that's from every testimony I've ever gotten. Dakota wants to thank you. Request that song, awesome song. Thank you. You make this whole world a lot better. Question, is it right to test the guy? I see girls do this a lot these days. Yep, and if they fail the test, send them to my website or dump them. No, I'm serious. Gary, can you hold up the Alpha Power Plus bottle and the Alpha Hormone Plus bottle? I can. Let's see why not. But I have to go over there to get them. These are basically the bottles. It's hard to read on the air. And just give them a little shake. What the heck? Never have too much alpha. You want to build muscle? Yeah, we don't have the ad campaigns of all the other shit that doesn't work. We don't have the money for that, but we have the results for that. I've got some super strong stuff, but not enough. I'm gonna have to sell that privately. But it's like steroids without the steroids. No side effects, nothing. I hang out with a lot of young guys as friends, and they're built like this. And what do we do? Two sets of five in the gym, we walk out, that's it. And guys are sure on something. Nothing but natural stuff. Nothing but natural stuff. Whew. But right now there is a sale happening at GaryBrodsky.com. And it's happening. I know, Alice, right now. Hit that site up. I'll be here. Questions, GaryBrodsky123@AOL.com. I know what you computer guys are saying, AOL. But let me tell you what's happening to guys even more today. Let me know if you see this. Every time I go on YouTube, what do I see? A million posts about how great it is to be an atheist. One second. And I am really sick of the atheists, okay? They get on my nerves. They really are getting on my nerves. First of all, have you ever heard an atheist speak that doesn't mean like this? Well, there's no God because you can't prove it. Now think about this. No God, no sex. Do you know why? You have sex with women, right? And women who have, yeah, I was a couple women watching. When you have sex, what do you say? Oh God, oh yeah, oh Jesus. What do you say when you're an atheist? What do women say? Oh, science? It doesn't work. Okay, I'm being silly, but atheists always are, can you prove there's a God? No, of course, the universe, you know, just happened by accident. Yeah, complete, total accident. You know, it's funny, but all these atheists, when they start dying, they start believing. You can't see them, how can you prove it? You know, and it's the same voice. Yes, I'm going to call Adam, actually. I forgot to get back to him. He got back to me. I've been busy all week, and I have about 75 messages in my phone. If you're one of them, sorry, I'll get to them. I have to listen them out and sit there for about 2 hours to get my messages. And it always is like this, you know, say your name, and then somebody honks their horn outside. It's like, that's not your name. Can you also show me the Benth bottle? The camera moving around will be easier. Okay, this is MK17. This is a bottle. Benth comes in. Here's Benth. Oh, I got it. I got someone. Benth. And this works. They both work. And we got them here. Hey, Jason is back. Gary, Jason again, your power of belief system rocks. And battle between male and female energies videos is great and they work perfectly. Everyone go buy it as if your life depends on it. Thanks, Jason. Dakota, how do you tell the difference if a guy is just flirting for fun or actually means something more? Dakota, okay, I know what you look like. You're one of the most beautiful women in the world. Any guy flirting with you means it, okay? End of story. It's not a discussion here, okay? That is a fact. Fact. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to take a break, and here's another song for Dakota. I just lost it here. 1 second. Ah, Dakota, this is for you. Thank you.
walking down the street, pretty woman, the kind I like to meet, pretty woman. I don't believe you, you're not the truth. No one could look as good as you.
Mercy.
Pretty woman, won't you pardon me, pretty woman?
Now that's how you write songs for women. Now songs, music is dead, passion is dead, life is dead. You got to bring it back in yourself to bring it out in other people. That is a fact. You got to bring it out in yourself to bring it out in other people. That is a fact. You see these zombies walking around, you know, and they're all unhappy because they're without passion. About anything, you're not going to be happy. And that's what today's medication does to you. Me, I prefer to stay my DHEA, my gold, and I have not been to a doctor since I got slapped in the ass when I was born, or since Pale had to put me in the hospital a few times. That was just a matter of casting and stuff like that. He broke a few bones on my body. You know? The Pale Head's out there somewhere. He's out there. Okay, I just from the title of this, David, we got something good here. And I bet you're on the same track. Not only atheism, but people don't know anything about the history of our country these days, unless it was something handpicked out by a part of a propaganda campaign. Just saying, David. David, I'm glad you brought up atheism and history, because here is the history of atheism. Very simple. Atheism comes in first. And it's happened with Germany, we all know about that one. Russia, we all know about that one. China. Atheism comes in first. What comes next? Mass murder of the population. Atheism always precedes that. And that alone should scare you right back to God. I get a lot of this. Well, if you're not an atheist, defriend me on Facebook. And I can't defriend anybody because, once again, I have suspended from Facebook for putting up religious sayings. But I can accept friends. So if you'd like to become my friend and get all the lazy info, hit me up. I'd be happy to be a friend on Facebook. I cannot request friends. I have limited posting ability because I say stuff. And I know, yeah, freedom of speech is guaranteed by the Constitution. But they just privatized it. It's on Facebook. It's on AOL. It's in chat rooms. Anywhere. You say something and somebody is offended, you're gone. What kind of a world is it where you can't offend anybody anymore? Fuck them, okay? I know a lot of people aren't working today in entertainment because they said something offensive. That was the whole fun of being a kid. Did you do your homework, Gary? Hey, fuck you, okay? You know, I was a son of a bitch in school. Now kids are starting early being brainwashed. How do you inspire them? How do you stop it? By not being brainwashed yourself. I had a dinner party here last night. I'm serious. What a bunch of brainwashed people were here. It's like and these are people my age, and they don't even look close to my age. They look like my grandfather. Not my real grandfather, but you know what I'm talking about. They were like, did you do your policies? Fuck no. And what about all your paperwork when you die? Not yet. I don't plan to die. What if you do die? I don't want to die. And listen to you, I don't think you're alive, even though you're speaking to me. Well, you got to get everything in order in case you die. That's what they talk about. Okay, that's what guys my age are talking about. Did you get a colonoscopy yet? No, I don't even feel like I've had something shoved up my ass at this point in my life yet. I don't know why. Just don't feel like I haven't done. And you should get one every month. No, not really. I don't think so. How do you know you don't have cancer? Well, if I start losing weight, I'll know. Oh, and then what will you do? I'll die like everybody fucking else. I'm not afraid to die. That's funny because I have a lot of doctors who are friends. I say to them, why are you my friend? I'm just curious. Because you're not a hypochondriac. You have no fear of death. It sort of scares the shit out of doctors. They sort of like it. I am sure I've had some serious illnesses in my life. And how do I cure them? Prayer. Yeah. Well, we forgot about that, right? That's not allowed these days. Are you crazy? Prayer? Oh, you got to be crazy. Wasn't crazy 30 years ago. In fact, it has been crazy since the beginning of the world. Now it's crazy. Yeah, I'm ranting tonight. Hey, Juan. Ah, Gary, I saw it. I just saw Wolf Falling Down with Michael Douglas. Great movie. Mr. Plus Sign, will the Adam webinar be expensive? That's actually a good question, because Adam gets all the money. He dictates the price, and he doesn't care whether you show up or not. All right, you did it. You got the Your Wish is Our Command ebook. Thank you, James. And the audio programs that go along with it. Hey, Jason here. Gary, why is it when you go to a store to buy clothes, they all look fake and real gay? Even my brother says the clothes look gay. Thanks, Jason. Because they're trying to promote, as I have it in the white papers here, homosexuality and the promotion of homosexuality. And this is not something I don't have the knowledge to format this on my computer. This is all their agenda right here. I got pages of this stuff. I do research. That's why you actually, when you buy stuff, you know, I use the money to research. I am so in debt from researching. I don't care. I have to get this message out. Now, there's a way you can help me, and it's easy, and it doesn't cost you anything. We have an affiliate program now. You can sell the stuff, and I'll do every private recording just for your website, wherever you want to sell it, and it pulls. Gary, Jason, when do you go to, okay, same question. The screening with a lot of A's. How come women are all into texting? Okay, I will answer that question. I'll text you the answer. Just kidding. Okay, women are into texting for one reason. There are so few guys out there that know how to actually talk that they have turned to texting and cats. That's their life. Because to most women, there are no real guys out there. And you could ask them, you ask them, do you think guys have become like a little sissified? They go, oh yeah, big time, way big time. So texting is their only and last basic communication. And if you're going to text, do it right. The texting game on sale now at GaryBrotsky.com. Now what's really funny is the other guys who consider themselves dating gurus promote the anti-male, anti-sexual agenda. And I think that is really a crime perpetrated on people. Not a crime punishable by death, just a crime for anybody who listens to it. Now, on our stuff, we have a guarantee. If you don't get women on any of our products, and you don't feel better, you don't feel great, you don't feel passionate, we send you, free of charge, the knife to cut it off with. Yeah, this is a new one. I like these toys. These are men's toys, okay? Let's get this again. We send you the knife to cut it off with. Now, I used to sell these on my website, and I had to take it down because you can't sell knives. It's dangerous. You know, it's really funny that everything that's male is dangerous. It's supposed to be. Men are about danger and taking chances. From Dakota. Thank you. You are too awesome. Gary, your wish is your command is incredible. I listen to it every day, and I encourage everyone to listen to it and apply it to their lives. And what is a sign the guy wants something more? The fact that he's a guy is a sign, okay? Because we're going to have to talk. It's easy to pick up women in person than online. Yes, 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 and yes. Why? Because in person, you know, like 70% to more seduction signs are not verbal or written down. Writings, you know, it's nice here and there. But in person, hey, looking great. Or rare typing, hey, you look great. But you just text me, how would you know? Well, there's a game you can play with texting, but no, in person is the only way. That's what I never understood. You know, Match.com, Harmony, eHarmony.com, all that stuff, where people have lost such, yeah, anybody on there, okay, don't date, okay? And that goes for women. Do not date these guys. They don't know how to pick up women. They don't know how to deal with women, so they go to a computer company and go, oh, please get me a girl. Fuck you, get your own girl. GaryBrotsky.com. Question. If World War III happens, will I still be able to buy gold? I gotta admit, that's the question of the night so far. That's how good this stuff is, okay? Yes. Unless we lose. No one can. Carl Anderson. Oh, I should not have said your last name. I apologize. That time's last name. It is important only alpha males as friends to separate from beta males. I have a few friends from high school that are still like sponges to the social programming and don't realize it. I feel like they are past the point of no return. Should I stop wasting my time on them and wake up and find some new friends? Yes, absolutely. Otherwise, their negativity will bring you down. It'll drag you down like a rock tied around your neck. Do you think Ron Paul will win a third party? I hope so, but like you, Alex, it's happening right now. No, I don't think so. They or somebody right now sitting around knowing who's going to win or lose. They don't have to worry. The election is all a big game. It's always neck and neck. It didn't used to be that way. It used to be one candidate like Reagan. He blew Carter out of the water. Now, they almost have the same policies. I don't know if they're making any predictions on who or what. A little off topic. In your research, have you seen anything that enhances memory or creativity? Oh, yeah. Passion increases everything. Zombies don't care. When you have life in your eyes, you don't have to worry about it. When you start saying, the biggest enemy to man and woman is being complacent, saying, oh, I hope this is just as bad things are and not going to get any worse, or I'll pick up somebody tomorrow. Most of the things, I'll get that question in a second, most things in your life, if you want to be wealthy, the main reason you're not wealthy, you ready for this? This is, I said in the last show, but it's that important. Is because if you take away your video time, your YouTube time, your television time, and you put that time into making money, you have no choice but to make money. And if you put that time into meeting women, you'll meet women. And if you have approach anxiety, I'm telling you right now, the gold, one drink, and approach anxiety is gone. We've got a new shipment in. Right now, hit it up, GaryBrotsky.com. Supplements. I mean, right today we sold a couple of hundred bottles, and before the inventory has to be re-upped or re-bought or repurchased, relabeled, get it now. When you say astral travel, do you still pick up and seduce women with modern alpha techniques? Yes. Bob! How are you? And welcome. Hey, Gary, I know you're an Oath Keeper. What is the general consensus among them about New World Order agenda? Thanks, Bob. It's the basic 10 rules that we will not follow. And the other question is, how do you know it's an Oath Keeper? But that's okay. Gary, Jason again. Yes, online dating of any kind sucks. I know. I have a friend that's doing it. He does online dating just to see how bad it is. And it's really funny. He doesn't do it because he wants to get a girlfriend. He wants to do it to see how bad things are. And he has been doing it for over 2 years. And every day is a horror story. Yes, Gary, Jason, yeah. Okay. Yes, online dating of any kind sucks. And online dating is programming and designed to keep people separated and apart from one another. Absolutely true. Can't argue with the truth. Can a guy in a wheelchair pick up women? Yes, absolutely. Women are so lonely today. So, out of no one to talk to, nothing. Yes, a guy in a wheelchair can pick up women. I have two friends who are in wheelchairs that have women who love them. Palohead sat in a wheelchair one day because we found one outside of the trains and he was sitting there until the owner came back. And some girl said, can I push you? He said, yes. She pushed him. He wasn't crippled. He dated her for like a month. She pushed him around everywhere. Finally, she saw him walk around. She goes, what were you doing in a wheelchair? You're not crippled. He goes, ah, lazy. Anyway, I'm taking a soda break and I'll be back. I'm going to play something different today. Ah, same shit. No, just kidding. No, something good. Don't like nerds. Okay. Very simple. Okay. Women will breed with the most powerful guy, just like in the animal kingdom. Why? Because they are, this is programmed into DNA, looking for the most powerful guy to have the most powerful children. They're looking for good offspring. So the more alpha guy is, the more you're going to get women. That simple. Absolutely. Yes, Alex. Absolutely. Yes. And Alex, and it's happening right now, Jones. Okay. Yes, it is absolutely true. Private question. But yes. Okay. Come on. Let's have some more questions. Time is running out. Anybody? Rodriguez? McPherson? Some Star Trek. I still like the old Star Trek. The guys actually had sex and fought. Oh, but nobody likes that. They like the new ones. Hi, I'm Captain Homosexual. No, it's just not the same. And it's all part of the social programming. Gary, when women go out, they're looking for a man, not another kid to raise. Oh, that says so well. And that's why everyone needs the alpha program. Thanks, Jason. And thank you, Jason, because that is exactly true. They don't want another kid. They want a man with passion, a man with life. A man that looks like a man, walks like a man, carries himself like a man. And to find out how, just go to GaryBryce.com. That easy. Everything's on sale. Get there now. You tree noms? Oh, man. It is rough. Ah, soda. It's badly fucking. Okay. I started getting like a little worse now. Because actually, this works on women. I'm smoking a cigarette like this, and women go, do you know what you're putting into your body? Go, hey, you know what I can put into your body? At first you get mad, it's like, they hang out and they talk. Women like bold men. Bold men get women. That simple. Bold men. I say this right on every audio program. If men knew how women thought, you'd be 20 times more bold. But if you want to buy some guts in a bottle, get the gold. Okay? Gold. Yeah, the golden rule. Whoever gets the gold makes the rules. You get the gold, you make the rules. Get it now before you have to sit and wait for it. Hey, Bobby! Also, okay. Bobby, do me a favor, email me your phone number. I will give you a call tomorrow. And this is from David. Isn't it also success as a person as much the alpha attitude that counts? We're intent to ask about what you have done, your ambitions, etc. David, oh yeah, but without the passion, what are you going to build in your life? I manage other people's money. Very good. Make your own. Bang! You know, I'm a hedge fund manager. Great. It's just, you know, the big business of America today, unfortunately, because we don't build anything anymore, is managing other people's money. And the man with many A's, a woman, it's a man. It's true that women do not have a choice who they're attracted to. False, okay? Sorry. False. Alpha up, and you ain't giving them a choice. Use MK-17, they have no choice. Every arsenal weapon you could possibly think of getting women is right there on GaryBoss.com. Get it all. Everything that's not nailed down. Because there's a sale going on right now. And Dakota, I want to hear from you. You're still watching. Because I'm going to do an exit song just for you. No, if you're not, I'm just going to do my own exit song. Okay. Back to the Gary Grotsky Show with Gary Grotsky. This is so much better than those horrible beefs. Took me, you know, a year to figure this out. I was watching TV, The Guardian. They said there's something funny there. The female looks for a partner to mate with and procreate. The human race is the only species that has a lawsuit follow right after sex. That is great. That is great. It's the old friend Dave from the old Block Talk Radio. I got to bring that back. And many people's religions today is political correctness and the idol being a slave submitting to their own death, taking in their trying to take masculine, wimpy voice while drowning in pools of synthetic estrogen where the cock and balls used to be. I have faith in you, thank you, in solving the problems that come your way. I love the brain train system. It showed that my faith in you is true and send the rest of my orders. I certainly will. Please play Thunderball. Don't know if I have Thunderball. As I said, the gold, silver, and copper just came in. It's going out, so get it tonight. Is it better to be calm or enthusiastic? Good question. Both. I'm doing it right now. Yeah, Eric, I don't know. I never tried with black duct tape, but the concept is there. They didn't have thread back then, so it should work, actually. It absolutely should work. Because spirits don't go, well, you know, you use duct tape and we really into this. No, it probably would work based on everything I know. Okay. General Brodsky, when is the Cult Channel about to start? Probably this Wednesday. I just got to get in touch with my web guy because I forgot my login information. And Dakota. And that's, this is the last question because it's up on midnight. Gary, it's 100% true. Girls don't want a little negative boy complaining all the time. They want a man with direction. Okay, that's from Dakota right there. God bless you, Gary, and God bless you, Dakota. And now, thank you everybody for watching. And this exit song is for Dakota. So I will talk through it.
All of my kissing.
So Dakota, that's for you, and I mean every word that's been said in the song. Yeah. Now, GaryBrodsky.com, ColeForce.com. So, I'll see you all next Sunday. Get to GaryBrodsky.com tonight. Just check it out. Not to buy anything. Guaranteed. Or otherwise, you get this.
stars appear and the shadows are falling.
Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much. See you guys next Sunday. Get on the webinar. They're great. You don't know what you